In this video, we are going to look at passive range of motion assessment of the hip joint.
Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description.
Hi and welcome to PhysioTudos. The goal of passive range of motion assessment is to assess the osteokinematic movements of a joint, to evaluate the range of motion in degrees, and if range of motion is limited, to evaluate the end feel. You can find a collection of different end feels in this table. According to studies by Charlton et al. In 2015 and Prather et al. In 2010, passive range of motion assessment of the hip joint had moderate to excellent intra-testor reliability and poor to excellent inter-testor reliability, depending on the movement that was examined. For flexion, have the patient in supine lying position close to the long edge of the treatment bench. Then palpate the anterior superior iliac spine on the side to be examined to monitor once end range of motion is reached and the pelvis starts to move. With the other hand, grab onto the distal femur with the lower leg, can rest on your forearm or stay in a flexed position. Then move into flexion and assess the end feel. For extension, have the patient in prone lying position close to the long edge of the bench. Then fixate the pelvis at the ischial tuberosity with the hypothenar aspect of one hand. With the other hand, grab onto the distal femur and perform passive hip extension and assess the end feel. For internal rotation, the first option is to test in 90 degrees of flexion while the patient lies supine. So bring the patient's leg into flexion while your forearm supports the lower leg and your hand can cup the knee to protect it against valgus torque when you perform internal rotation. You can also assess internal rotation with the hip in neutral. This can be done in supine with the leg hanging over the edge of the bench or in prone position where you again fixate the ischial tuberosity. For external rotation, the same applies as for internal rotation. So you can test in both 90 degrees of hip flexion in supine position or in neutral hip position. For abduction, the patient lies in supine position close to the long edge of the bench. With one hand, palpate the ipsilateral anterior superior iliac spine with the thumb. The remaining fingers of that hand can stay in contact with the bench. With your other hand, pick up the patient's leg at the knee so that the patient's lower leg is supported on your forearm and perform abduction passively, while your other hand monitors movement at the pelvis once you approach end range and assess the end feel. For adduction, the patient lies in supine position with the foot of the non-tested leg placed laterally to the knee of the leg to be examined. The patient's leg is supported on your forearm, and the thumb of the other hand palpates the anterior superior iliac spine on the contralateral side to monitor movement at the pelvis. All right, if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, now's the time to do so. We hope you enjoyed the video, and if you want to watch more, check the recommended video right next to me. For more information on our assessment products, check the description down below. And as always, this was Andreas for PhysioTudos. I'll see you next time. Bye.